Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله سبحانه وتعالى is the one God which each one of us depend on, and he is the one and only God that we believe in. But he calls himself in many different ways to prove that he is only one. And he is unique. And among the names, he calls himself Al-Witr. He calls himself as Al-Witr, the unique, the odd, the uneven. If you look at this, Al-Witr doesn't stand for only the odd as in one. Over here, it means unique. Allah is unique. Where do we find this word? We find it in the Quran and we find it in a hadith also. If you look at the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Fajr, verse number 3, وَالشَّفْعِ وَالْوَتْرِ. And the two verses, the two raka'ahs that you do before the witr itself, which is the one raka'ah. This proves to us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one. Imagine, if Allah was to be even, doesn't that mean he could be divided? But because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regarded himself as the odd, as the unique, that means he is alone and alone will be he. He wouldn't be the same as anyone. Bear this in mind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also describes himself in a hadith where the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was explaining about him when he said, لِلَّهِ تِسْعَ وَتِسْعِينَ إِسْمًا. To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala belongs 99 names. Man hafidhaha, the one who will memorize them, dakhal al-jannah, he would enter jannah. Fa inna Allah witrun yuhibbu al-witra. And indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is unique and he loves uniqueness. How does this benefit us? How can we draw close to this and how can we work upon it? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us not only to regard him as unique, but because he loves witr, we know among the witr that we have to do is salatul witr itself. Is salatul witr, is the prayer of witr, is the prayer of one unit that we do as the last prayer in every single day. Not only that, the reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala regarded himself as unique, in the Quran, he also says that in Surah Muhammad, he says, وَلَن يَتِرَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ. You know what's amazing about this verse? The word yatir is brought in a verb tense. It is not a noun. Witr is a noun, which means everlasting. But verb changes. But how does it not change in this case? Because he started with lan, and lan means never ever would it change. It would remain that way. So what does it mean in this verse? It means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just enough and he does not deprive. Allah does not deprive and does not take away anything from anyone. And what did he mean exactly on this verse? وَلَن يَتِرَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ. And he would never ever deprive you from your deeds. Whether you feel that you are not succeeding, whether you feel you're not working hard enough, whether you feel there's more you can do than what you are doing right now, the much you are doing at the moment, Allah will never deprive you from it. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls himself Al-Witr. And if we understand the word Al-Witr, we would work harder and even more, not only for Allah as he describes himself to be unique and the only one who exists as the one Lord of this earth, but also we would know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would never snatch away from us that which we deserved and work for it. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just. Let's work for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and fulfill this name just like how he wants us to do so.